Today's episode, we're going to wrap up the construction of this great little drink carrier, and I'm probably just going to end up dropping some more drinks into it and heading outside and kicking back for the rest of the weekend.
Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop, sponsored by SawStop, North America's number one cabinet saw. For more information, visit sawstop.com. By Highland Woodworking, fine tools delivered to your door since 1978. Visit their website at highlandwoodworking.com. By Lee Valley and Veritas, with over 5,000 high-quality woodworking hand tools, visit their online catalog at leevalley.com. And by Centipede Tool, a revolution in sawhorse evolution. Visit their website at centipedetool.com.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. As I mentioned, we're going to go ahead and wrap up the construction of this great little drink carrier that we have here, made completely from some scrap material that I had laying around. Although, and I'll talk about this a little bit towards the end, when it comes to the design, I have a couple other ideas for other ones that I will probably end up making or will consider making, including the dimensions and even the materials themselves, because I have some ideas on that might really work out and make it really gorgeous. The kind of thing that people are going to fight over to want to get one of these. But anyways, though, we're going to go ahead and jump right back into where we left off. And last episode, we went ahead and did some milling. We did a little bit of joinery work. And now we need to kind of shape this middle divider right here, which we're going to do over at the bandsaw. And then we're going to go ahead and start assembling it, because pretty much at this point, this is really the only thing that we have left to do. One thing I am going to mention is I'm going back to my regular microphone I have here. When I recorded all this, I was playing with a new microphone, and I like the sound that I'm getting, but because it's so hot out right now, we have the air conditioning on, I have a feeling that the air conditioner will overwhelm it, so I'm going to try and balance out the sound on this. So please forgive me a little bit here if it's kind of up and down, but I promise I'll try and get it as equalized as possible. But anyways, with all that information out of the way, let's go ahead and head right over to the bandsaw where we're going to make this nice little arc here. Now we're over here at the bandsaw, and we're just going to go ahead and cut out this kind of egg shape, I guess is the only way I can describe it. And this is pretty much the body of the middle support, and this will also be our handle. So we'll just go ahead, cut this out, and then we'll put a couple of holes in here. We'll make some sort of oblong hole here for our handle itself. And then the middle portion here is almost done. We're pretty much ready for assembly. So remember how I had mentioned that this middle divider had a break in it? Well, I went ahead and I really forced the break, but I kept the fibers intact and went ahead and glued it. The result is this picture here, and once I did a little hand planing, cleaned up that glue line, nobody was ever the wiser. In fact, maybe I should have just never said anything. Now that that repair has been made on this and we have it all shaped, I want to go ahead and just finesse this curve. So we're going to come in here, we'll drop it into our vise. I can put it on an angle just slightly. We're going to use our spokeshave just to remove just a little bit of material, not much, just to kind of clean it up a little from the bandsaw. So I'm just going to finesse it. I can feel a spot right in here that it's not catching the right way. There. I think that works pretty good. Maybe we'll just come in. We'll even chamfer it just slightly this way, so it feels comfortable in our hand. And then once I have this done, I'll get a little tear out up there. There. So flip it over. And I'll repeat it on this side. Now, one more thing that I want to do before I finish assembling this is I want to create two, maybe three holes for where I can let my fingers in here to hold on to the handle, as we'll call it. And the way I did this is I plan on using this 1-inch Forstner bit to drill my hole. I came up from the bottom approximately about 3.5. I'm kind of making these up as I go. And I found the center point of the handle itself. So I said, all right, I want one of these ridges of the Forstner bit, the rim, to come awful close to there, if not right on it. In fact, let's just go ahead and line it up, drop it down, and essentially we're going to create two holes that are kind of overlapping each other. So I've got my starter holes, I'm just gonna go ahead and chuck this up. We'll drill these, and we'll see how it goes. Maybe we'll connect the dots with some chisels. So, anyways, let's experiment. Before I go through this all the way, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and let me put down a little backer board here. I don't know why I didn't think about doing that before. And I know some of you will be saying, why aren't you clamping that in place? I feel confident enough with what I'm doing. So anyways, let's finish this up. There it goes. So we are through. All right, doesn't look bad on the other side. Let's go ahead and finish up filling these two holes and let's see what this does. There we go, and we're through. And it doesn't look too bad. I think I will take a chisel. Well, that feels pretty good, but I think I will take a chisel, so let's go ahead and grab it. And let's just connect those dots. And we'll have to do a little cleaning up of this, maybe with a rasp, to give us a real good feel. But hey, that's not so bad.
Now to really give the handle opening here a nice finished look, what I ended up doing was using my widest chisel, I went ahead and just pared the material until I got pretty decent lines. I just eyeballed it, no need to get really technical with it. And then I ended up coming back in with one of my finest rasps and cleaned up the lines and kind of feathered these edges so that it has a nice smooth feeling to it. And you really only need it to be like a few fingers wide, just enough to get in there so that you can hold on to it while you're carrying it. But just really kind of maybe sand it around, give it a nice little chamfer, a nice little round over, and it's gonna feel amazing. Now that the middle divider is all set here, and we've got our finger holds and we've got all the joinery set, it's time to start assembling it. And the first thing I did was I assembled the sides and the slats. As you can see, I have three slats on each side. They don't have to be uniform. You can play with this as much as you want to. You can have a couple of them, or maybe you could even have solid sides. That's completely up to you. I also made a couple of bottom slats. Obviously, we don't want our drinks falling out the bottom. Again, they don't have to be this wide. They can be just enough to cover the bottom, but I had the extra material sitting there, so I figured, why fuss with it? When it came to assembling the actual box itself, I did nothing more than just some glue and butt joints because I planned on coming back in, and you can kind of see the little detail here. I've got these small brass brads, and we'll talk about those in just a second. But I just glued it up, and really I just used some plain old painter's tape, in fact my usual little blue painter's tape, to act as a clamp, and it worked perfectly fine. Now I had mentioned early on I planned on using polyurethane glue because of the fact that it is water resistant, but what I ended up doing was just using just regular old yellow Gorilla glue, just the regular wood glue, because it also has a water resistance. This obviously isn't going to be dropped into the water, so I think I'm doing fine here. I'm not really concerned about it, so just regular old yellow glue will work great. And the nice thing about that is it's not going to expand and push things all over the place. Once I had these all glued up, the next thing was to turn my attention to getting the middle divider and those vertical dividers in place. So let's go ahead and take a look. I shot some really good footage with this, well, some decent footage to give you an idea of my process of getting this in here just the right way.
Now normally I don't show the glue up, but this one, let's see what we can do. So I'm gonna get some glue into this joint, not too much, just because this really isn't like a structural piece. This will actually be attached not only here, but all right, so both of those are glued in place. And another thing I did is on the inside, you can't really see it very well, but I have a mark here and one there. That tells me the depth of how far this is gonna sit in. So I'm gonna apply glue to about those marks. And again, the glue isn't what's really gonna be holding this in place. It's gonna help. I'm gonna use some mechanical fasteners. So let's get those, let's get this glue kind of set up here a little bit. And we'll smear it around inside that. Lot there. All right, and then now goal here is to set this in place. And I keep looking at the bottom here just for on the safe side. I marked which slots are which, and the more I think about it, it doesn't really matter once I get this in place where they are, because they're both doing the same exact thing anyway. So let's go ahead and persuade this in. Everything lined up where I want it. Make sure these middle pieces are up where they're supposed to be. And I actually want them flush with this top side here. So let's see what we can do. Get as close as possible. Alright, so that's good. Alright, I'm gonna put a clamp. Just to kind of hold that in place. And then now these. Let's try and square these up the best we can. Actually, I can square this up. All right. Before I apply the mechanical fasteners. That way there's no... All right. Perfect. So, next thing, we'll let this glue up, and then we're going to nail the mechanical fasteners in place.
All right, and that's really all there is to the construction of this great little drink carrier. I did come back in, and like I had mentioned, I put some brass brads on each end here, and I did the same thing for the vertical dividers and also for this middle divider, just to help reinforce it. I'm confident the glue will really kind of keep things in place, but you never know. Maybe it will work its way a little bit. Who knows how abusive you are with this, so it's nice to have some sort of special reinforcement. And it definitely worked out really great. In fact, my friends who saw this were just like, they really, really loved it. And I think I have a feeling that I'm gonna be making some more of these. One thing with the design, I had mentioned in the beginning that a suggestion I have is maybe if you are very intentional on what you want to do with this, use a material like say like a teak or a white oak is something I have laying around that I know I could come back in. It's rather water resistant is probably the best way to describe it. It holds up really well against moisture, and on top of it, it's going to look really, really beautiful. So that's something I'll probably end up doing at some point. You don't have to use this thin material. Again, this is 1/4 inch, 5/16 of an inch material. You could use some really thick material. In fact, what I really want to do is I want to have something just a little bit thicker because I have this really great bottle opener that I thought about attaching to the edge here, and this material is just way too thin to have it on without it possibly breaking. So it might be neat to have a bottle opener right built into it. That would be a lot of fun. Of course, you could always attach one with like a string or something if you happen to need one. Another option is this particular case was built specifically for standardized glass bottles, which end up being about 2.5 inches in diameter. So if you want to carry, say, larger pop bottles, say like a 16-ounce bottle or something, just go ahead and measure it and you can adjust the sizes for it. In fact, I think I might end up doing that on a specific one because it turns out my grape sodas didn't necessarily fit in here, at least the plastic bottle grape sodas didn't. One other thing I might mention is if you find when you go to put these in my particular situation, I had measured these and apparently while bratting them in and gluing it in place, one kind of slid a little bit. So these middle openings kind of gave me a little bit of an issue. I just came back in with my rasp, or you could use maybe a chisel or just some coarse sandpaper or something. And I just removed a little bit of material on the inside here and it opened it up enough so that I could get the bottle in and out without any issues whatsoever. So that's really the only thing I can think of off the top of my head when it comes to design. One more neat thing, actually, I just thought about this as I was looking in here. The way that I have this groove, I could have done a stop groove, which would have made putting the middle divider in place really easy, but by having this full groove going from top to bottom, I actually discovered that this middle divider, the part that sticks up the most, if I say built two or three of these to these exact dimensions, they actually would stack one right on top of the other. So I could just set them aside without having to worry about, you know, like, well, how am I going to get those to stand there? So just a neat little thing for maybe storage when it's no longer summer and you're like, oh, what am I going to do with these? But anyhow, again, thanks for stopping by. If you have any comments, questions, suggestions, I would love to hear them. Leave me an email at mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com, or you can leave me a comment over at mattsbasementworkshop.com. If you're watching this on YouTube, you can leave me a comment over there. I love hearing from all of you, and I'd love to hear some of your ideas about maybe an improvement or a suggestion, or maybe send me some pictures of yours, so we can always kind of play around with all of these various aspects of it. So anyways, I look forward to hearing from all of you. Until the next episode, straight grains and sharp blades. Which drink am I going to put in here next?
Thanks for watching. To find even more videos and woodworking-related content, be sure to visit our website at mattsbasementworkshop.com. You can also find us on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. And don't forget to subscribe to the show either on YouTube, in iTunes, or you can even receive email notifications whenever we post something new.